What's up, guys? I got a Black Ops gameplay for you here on the map Crisis. Using the FN Foul with dual mag attachment, cheetah shit camo, and I like tiger camo on a lot of things. I know it's overused and all, but it does look good on a lot of guns. Some guns it kind of looks weird, but on the FAL and the M14 in specific, I think it looks really good. My perks are Hardline Pro, Hardened Pro, and Ninja Pro. And this was the last game I played before my little break from Black Ops, and you'll see why. I took like a 2-week break after playing this, and just for, you know, personal reasons, just trying to get things in my life sorted out before gaming, because while gaming is fun, of course, I think real life should come first, always. And you might notice a weird noise in the background. That's my fan. It's snowing here today, and it's really quiet when it snows. Like, there's no passing vehicles, there's no birds really chirping or anything like that. And it's so quiet that I just need some background noise just going, because I don't know how many other people have to do this, but I have to turn this fan on at night when I sleep, or I can't sleep just because it's so quiet. Like, I need some kind of background ambient noise to help me out in that regard to go to sleep. But the semi-automatic weapons in Black Ops are actually very, very good. And when picking between the FAL and the M14, they're basically identical as far as damage goes. The recoil is different, though. The FAL kind of kicks in a circular motion, while the M14 only really kicks up. If you add the grip to the M14, it definitely helps it as far as keeping your shot on target. So really, it's just preference which one you like. I think I like the FAL a little bit more, just based on the iron sight. If the M14's iron sight was better, I would probably like it more, because although these guns are similar, the FAL has some pretty nasty hip accuracy. Like, it's a little too wide or whatever compared to the other assault rifles, whereas the M14 has the same hip accuracy as the other assault rifles. So that's one little discrepancy a lot of people don't know about when picking the M14 or the FAL, whatever. The M14 does have tighter hip accuracy, and it will be better close range and close range engagements. But yeah, it's snowing here today, and there's really nothing to do, so I figured I'd do a commentary over some gameplay here. This is on my newish gamer tag, so I tried to blur out the kill feed and stuff to make sure that people couldn't see it and spam me with messages and friend requests and all that good stuff. So it's not that hard to edit in either, the little blur. It's easier than I thought, so I'm just going to start doing that from now on. Sorry if it's distracting, but I had an issue with people, like, you know, trying to bother my friends, and it's just a really big mess, and it kind of freaks me out that people would go to that link to, try to add my friends and pretend to be friends with them. Like, it's just really hard to explain. I don't even want to explain it because it's really awkward, but I do pick up a Stoner with a reflex sight and a really weird reticle, but that's really all I want to say about the gameplay. I mean, I think that you guys like to hear more about, the general consensus is you like to hear more about just whatever I want to talk about as opposed to the gameplay. And I'm getting ready to go out to eat. My friends are coming over, and they're going to pick me up, because I really don't want to drive in this snow. I have a two-wheel drive car, and they have a big SUV, so I'm kind of waiting on them to show up. Hopefully they don't show up, you know, mid-commentary, but what can you do? But yeah, how are you guys doing? Let me know in the comments what's up. I do enjoy reading the comments, and at least on my commentary videos, it seems like whenever I post a video that goes kind of viral, like any kind of emblem video I post seems to go viral and get put on the homepage, and I read some of the dumbest comments like I've ever read when my videos do that. And although getting more views is nice because I earn more money from it, it can also be very annoying when you get people like not speaking proper English and going, "Durr, you are faggot for posting this emblem, durr." Like they say stuff like that, and it's, I don't know, I feel dumber every time I read it, so I try not to read the comments after a few days on the videos. They get really popular. This is pretty cool. I get napalm striked, and I'm in the water, so me and my teammate are both in the water, and we survive it. That is really cool. That's a really cool feature. I don't know why. I just think it's cool. In Battlefield, actually, Bad Company 2, if you're in the water in cold levels, like icy, wintry levels, if you don't get out within like 10 seconds, you freeze to death. Just a really... I like little cool features like that in these games. I think they add a lot to the immersiveness, if nothing else. Or just so you can say, wow, that's cool, at least once. But yeah, I call it my napalm strike here, and I even have to blur out the little title card, so you guys probably can't see my little 7-ball emblem, but I recently switched over to the Call of Duty 4 emblem, and in that emblem video I made of the Call of Duty 4 emblem, I was surprised to see how many people didn't get it and didn't know it was Call of Duty 4. Like, I guess people, I'm still surprised. I mean, I've been playing video games since I was 3 years old, so I guess I'm just surprised to see people just now getting into gaming and just now getting into Call of Duty, or not knowing what that is. Like, it just strikes me as weird. I've actually had people on my Super Mario Bros. 3 Let's Play, which I am continuing. I will put out an episode pretty soon of that, for those wondering. It just surprises me how many people seriously ask, like, what game is this, or is this on Xbox Live Arcade? Like, I mean, I'm 21 years old, so I'm definitely not an old man, and I don't know, it just strikes me as weird. Like, even I know games on Atari and stuff, like, I can recognize all that. I don't know, I guess I just grew up privileged with a lot of games. I'm going to fast forward this chopper gunner here because you guys don't really care to see me killing red squares, I guess. But, you know, growing up, I grew up with an NES, and since I was born in 89, the NES was faltering around then, and like I said, I've been playing since I was 3, so I was able to buy a lot of cheap games for the NES, and I think I had over, like, around 80 NES games by the time I was about 10 years old. Just because they were so cheap and they were so easily accessible, because the Super Nintendo was out then, and I don't know, I've had a lot of experience with older games, so it just kind of surprises me that other people haven't. We actually lose this game though, and it's just, I went 27-2 and we actually lost, and I couldn't believe, like, I really couldn't believe that, honestly, but, you know, what can you do? I guess not everybody can be, or not everybody can, you know, get good scores all the time, so, you know, But anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. It feels a little rushed. I kind of want to talk more about stuff, but I guess I could just do a commentary tomorrow or something. But anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Please rate it with a thumb up if you did, and leave a comment. Let me know how you guys are doing, because, like I said, I enjoy reading your comments, and I'll see you guys later.